In this video, we'll be looking at how to create a shared btrfs partition for sharing our Steam game library between Bazzite and Windows. We'll be doing the following together. We'll make our shared btrfs partition via a GParted live USB. Install the WinBtrfs driver in Windows. Configure WinBtrfs to use the correct permissions. Then we'll set up Steam in Windows to use our btrfs drive for our Steam library. Then we'll jump over to Bazzite and we will make our drive auto mount in Bazzite. And then finally, we'll set Steam in Bazzite to use our btrfs drive for our Steam library. Before we start, remember to back up anything important, as resizing partitions may result in data loss if it goes wrong. Now let's start by shrinking our Bazzite partition to make space for our shared btrfs partition. For this process, we'll be using a GParted live USB drive. Here we're going to shrink our Bazzite partition. And we're going to make a new btrfs partition for our shared games. We wait for the operation to apply. Cool, we're done with GParted. Let's boot into Windows. Open your browser and search for WinBtrfs. You're looking for a GitHub project. Here's the GitHub project. We go to releases and we're going to download the zip file for btrfs. Okay, let's extract the zip file. Right click on the btrfs ini file, click on install. Now it isn't picking up any btrfs drives. That's because there is a secure boot workaround that we need to do. If you don't have secure boot enabled, you don't need to do this piece. But we need to open up regedit. I go to hkey local machine, system, current control set, control, CI, policy, and inside of policy we need to make a new D word called upgraded system and set its value to 1. And we need to restart the machine. Now we can see the drives, but we'll run into another issue. Any file that we create from Windows will not be readable in Bazzite without switching to a sudo user. Let's fix this. Open the command prompt and run whoami/user. Take note of the SID, which we're going to copy. Now open regedit. Go to hkey local machine, system, current control set, services, btrfs, mappings. And over here, we're going to make a new D word, paste in the name of the SID of our user, and we need to give it a decimal value of 1000. Go into group mappings, and we need to do the exact same thing. Make a D word, put in the name or paste the name of our user SID, and we need to give it the decimal value of 1000. Do the same for this entry over here. We're going to change this one also to 1000. If we don't change this one, then any services that are running on the drive from the Windows side that creates files will not be accessible via the Bazzite side. Next, we want to hide our Bazzite partition from Windows so we don't make accidental edits to the drive. Right-click on your Bazzite partition, click on Properties, and click on the btrfs tab. Take note of the UUID. Now open up RegEdit. We're going to open that drive, and we're going to add a dword with the name ignore, and we'll give it the property of 1. Now we want to restart the machine for our changes to take effect. Let's open up Explorer. Now we shouldn't be able to see our Bazzite drive anymore, and we should just be able to see the games partition. Let's do the next part. We open up Steam, and we're going to make the btrfs games partition our default game partition. For that, we are going to Storage, Add Drive, and we add our games drive. Switch to the newly added drive, and we want to make that the default. And just to check that everything works, I'm going to install a game. The game has installed successfully. Let's have a look at our btrfs properties. And one thing to take note of, make sure that your user and group are both 1000. If it isn't, go back to RegEdit and make sure that you assign those values as numeric and not hexadecimal, like I did the first time I tried this. Let's carry on our configuration in Bazzite. First, we need to make our mount point. So we open up the terminal and we type sudo makedir /var /mnt/games. Type in your password. Now we've got our mount point ready for the next step. Next, we need to open up KDE Partition Manager. Type in our password again. And we need to set a mount point. So we're going to right click on this partition, edit mount point, select UID. In the path, we're just going to type var mnt games, exactly where we created that folder. We're going to untick all the options and click on more. Now for this part, I'm going to copy this next piece from the Bazzite documentation. So we're just going to go to docs.bazzite.gg and look for KDE Partition Manager Auto Mount Guide. And we're going to scroll down to the properties that we want to give for btrfs. And we're going to copy and paste this into KDE Partition Manager over there. Click on OK. And click on OK. You'll get a warning that this will edit the FS tab file. We do want to do that, so click on Save Changes. We're also going to go back to the documentation, and it will tell us to run this command to check that everything is fine. So we're just going to copy that, and we're going to paste this to our terminal. And if we get no output, everything is good and everything looks good. However, let's check if we've got permission to create files or folders. And as you can see, we don't. If you don't have permission either, then open up the terminal and run sudo chown $\user:\var\mnt\games. And put in your password. Now, if you jump back to Dolphin, if you right click, you can see we've got permission to create files and folders. Now, Right click on Steam, select Settings, select Storage, click on the drop down, select Add Drive, and we can add our VOM mount games. Click on Add, select it, and make it the default. And we should be able to see our game that we downloaded in Windows, which we should be able to just launch. As you can see, it's a bit of a process to create a shared btrfs partition for sharing your games between Bazzite and Windows. Thank you for watching. I hope that you found this guide helpful. Have a lovely day. Goodbye.